Hi, Jan.
Hi, Liz.
You've written a new report for Goldman Sachs Research exploring the merits of a national face mask mandate. Face masks are a health issue. They've also become a political issue. And now you're framing the wearing of face masks as an economic issue. Can you explain?
Yeah, it's an economic issue because it can substitute for lockdowns. So the issue that has preoccupied markets in recent weeks is that we've seen a significant deterioration in the US virus numbers concentrated in the Sun Belt, Florida, Texas, Arizona, to some degree California and other southern states. And that has basically raised fears that we may need to go back to the lockdowns that we saw back in March and April. We know that that's very economically damaging. What we show in the report is that one alternative to these lockdowns is to increase the use of face masks. Face masks are very effective in reducing virus spread. That would bring down, by our estimates, the growth rate of confirmed virus cases significantly and reduce the need for what otherwise would be a significant hit to the economy.
What does the data show about the effectiveness of mask wearing generally?
We find that mask wearing is very effective in reducing virus growth. And we look at this in a few different ways, both on a cross-regional perspective in the US, where we basically relate state-level face mask mandates to changes in infection numbers. And we find that within a couple of weeks of a face mask mandate, we see a slowdown in the virus numbers. We also look internationally at the relationship between face mask mandates and virus spread and actual changes in face mask usage and virus spread. And it's interesting that when you look at things in a bunch of different ways, often you find somewhat contradictory results when you do these sort of analyses. But in this case, we actually find very consistently that face masks work in bringing down virus spread.
So we've seen different approaches to face mask wearing around the world. Where are we seeing the most success?
Yeah, the most success we've probably seen in Asia. Asia has done a very good job containing virus spread. And it also is the region with the highest rates of face mask usage. Face mask usage in epidemics or just when people are sick has always been very high in Asia. We find about 90% of people in East Asia wear face masks basically as a matter of course. And that's at the very high end. In Europe, we've seen big increases in face mask wearing, especially in Southern Europe, which of course were Italy and Spain were hit particularly hard by the pandemic. And they've now also brought down their rates of virus spread to very, very low levels. We still have lower numbers in more Northern European countries and in the US. Germany and the US are close to 70%. And the UK is only at about 30%, and Scandinavia is the lowest at about 10%. So, there's a lot of variation in face mask wearing, which is, from a researcher's perspective, very useful because it allows you to basically tease out the relationship between face mask wearing and virus outcomes.
So what about in the United States? Obviously, a lot of variation here, state to state.
There are a lot of differences in the US. The Northeast has the highest rates of face mask wearing, and some of that is probably related to the fact that especially the tri-state area had such a bad outbreak, but it's more generally true in the Northeast. Generally, the South is somewhat lower. There's variation across states. And of course, this is also all based on self-reported data, which may not always be so accurate, but in general, the South has lower rates.
So what kind of impact on transmission rates do you think a national face mask mandate might have in the United States?
Our statistical estimates would say that a national mandate would raise the rate of face mask wearing from maybe 70% to maybe 85%. And that gives us a decline in the daily growth rate of infections from about 1.6% currently to about 0.6%. So, you know, large decline in the growth rate that we think would be concentrated in those parts of the US that currently don't have statewide face mask mandates, many of which are in the South, and that are currently seeing the biggest increases in infection. So we think it'd be pretty effective.
And what about the economic impact?
So in order to bring down the infection growth rate from 1.6% to 0.6%, we can use our estimates to figure out how much of a lockdown of activity you would need to see to get an equivalent effect. And our estimate is that it would be a lockdown worth about 5% of GDP. This is all based on statistical relationships. So clearly, these numbers are all measured with error. And we have to be aware that we're dealing in the world of probabilities and statistics here. But we feel pretty confident that it would be a meaningful effect, and therefore even the economic value of a face mask mandate could be quite high.
So Jan, does it have to be a national mandate, or do you think there are other ways to achieve this kind of progress?
It wouldn't have to be a national mandate. You could also have an increase in statewide mandates that ultimately have a similar impact. At the moment, only about 20 states have statewide mandates, and some of the worst affected states in the south of the country do not, Florida and Texas, for example. So if you did have a just much more pervasive state or city level move towards face masks, that could have some of the same effects. But a national mandate would be, you know, a more straightforward and potentially quicker way of getting there.
Thanks, Jan.
All right, thank you.